Today we learn the science of the Winter Olympics. As some of you might know, the Olympics are a televised sporting event where thousands of athletes from around the world compete for different medals. The events feature summer and winter games, alternating every 2 years. But what you might not know is the detailed science of how these games work and operate, which is what I aim to show you today. One of the most extreme sports in the Winter Olympics is the skeleton, a sport which involves rocketing headfirst down an icy track on a tiny sled. Riders compete in 4 timed runs, which are added up, and the rider with the shortest time wins. According to Olympic.org, the skeleton is known as the world's first ever sliding sport. The top men's athlete was Yeon Sung-bin, a Korean athlete with a time of 50.02 seconds. He is 23 years old and is nicknamed Iron Man after his red racing suit and his helmet's similarity to the comic books. The top female finalist was Lizzie Arnold, an athlete from Great Britain with a time of 51.46 seconds. She is 29 years old and her top speed is 90 miles per hour. And now for the science.
What? Science is for nerds!
Not you again!
You nerd!
No, it's fun science, trust me.
There is no such thing as fun science!
The skeleton sled can go 80 miles per hour.
That doesn't even sound that fast!
Actually, it's incredibly fast. Let me show you. First step, I'm just going to measure the distance between our start point and our end point. So I'm going to put this here. Stop. Now I'm going to go measure. Okay, and it looks to be about 40 feet. And we're going to go get a skateboard to demonstrate how fast. Okay, now I'm gonna record the clip with the skateboard.
Now I'm ready.
Okay guys, I have my clip and I'm ready to do some math. Okay, so I'm going to convert 80 miles per hour into feet per second. And then next, I'll divide 40 by that number to get around 0.33. This means that it would take about a third of a second to get that far. And now we'll speed this clip up to get the final result.
Now I'm ready.
So how does a rider go that fast without external propulsion? One of the factors is the surface. The ice produces friction, the force that slows down objects through surface interactions, freeing the sled from a force that slows it down.
Another key element is aerodynamics, which is a study of the interaction between air and things moving through it. To win, athletes must be as aerodynamic as possible to reduce wind resistance, a form of friction, and reach maximum speed. A more spread out concave object will be less aerodynamic than a tighter convex object. Therefore, athletes have to be still, straight, and streamlined. And that's how the science of the skeleton works. Next, we look at the science of curling.
Curling is a team sport where 2 teams of 4 players try to score by pushing a 44-pound rock at a circular target that looks like a bullseye called the house. Each player throws 2 stones. The other teammates sweep the ice, but more on that later. The team whose rock is closest to the center wins, and every additional rock that's closer to the center than the leading other team's rock also scores. After all the ends have been played, whoever has the most points wins.
The men's curling gold medalist team was the USA curling team, led by 4-time Olympian John Schuster. The 35-year-old began his international career playing lead for the Pete Fensen rink. The women's curling gold medalist team was the Sweden curling team, led by Anna Hasselberg. The 28-year-old curler is a former world junior champion skip. But how does curling work?
A key factor in curling is the sweeping. People used to think that the sweeping cleared out snow and the other debris, but as it turns out, the sweeping serves a different purpose. Like we talked about earlier, an object moving on a surface's greatest enemy is friction, and the rapid sweeping of the room helps melt the ice. This creates a thin layer of water, which greatly reduces friction, allowing the curling stones to be thrown up to 10 feet further. Who knew there could be so much science in a sport created in Scotland hundreds of years ago? I wonder if there's any science behind all the screaming.
She will be Canadian champion if she makes this shot. A most difficult attempt.
Neil!
Trying to come in off a stone on the outside. Trying to get in on it frantically. There's the contact. There's the roll. She's made it.
Downhill skiing is a sport where your only goal is to reach the bottom as fast as possible. Athletes soar as fast as 100 miles per hour, with their only protection against the elements and the speed being a thin suit.
The top women's downhill skiing athlete was Sofia Gaggia from Italy. The 25-year-old athlete competed on the European Cup circuit until 2016. The top men's downhill skiing athlete is Axel Lund Svindal from Norway. The 35-year-old is best friends with his teammate Kjetil Jansrud. But what is the science?
To start the run, the skier pushes off from the top, giving an extra push of energy. The main brunt of the work, however, is done by gravity. The gravity works to provide increasing acceleration to the skier, but speed's biggest enemy is back again, friction. When a skier puts her ski in the snow, it provides maneuvering capabilities, but it creates friction, which slows the rider down. Another part of eliminating friction is keeping their body tight and compact, and staying low to the ground on jumps. These things help eliminate air and wind resistance, speeding the rider up. And that is the science of the Winter Olympics.
I'm sorry if I look a little different. I shaved my beard. #YesShaveMarch.